Let me guess. Your headache this summer is caused by the heat, the air conditioner electricity bills, the PV production that goes unpaid into the public grid, while during the dark hours you purchase the kilowatt hour back at 35 euro cents per kilowatt hour. Now here's a solution. A second-hand mobile airco that absorbs a constant 700 watts from your solar panels. This converted airco produces not only 2 kilowatts of cold, but also 2.5 kilowatts of heat. Use it for showers or feed it into washing machine or dishwasher. Moreover, you store both the heat and the cold into dirt cheap thermal batteries so that you can have cooling and showers also after sunset, even during blackouts.
Whoa.
Oh yeah!
Hi Norbert here, I'm energy engineer. In video number 108, I explain how to realize double efficiency with a second-hand common heat pump. Combine it with very cheap and safe energy storage and replace the air conditioners in the whole house. And also have heating in the winter. I actually cut the connection between our central heating system on natural gas and the radiator network. In this video 71 here of last year, it quickly got 106,000 views, which is incredible for my small channel of less than 7,000 subscribers. So I decided to improve the concept. You store cold and heat separately in 2,000 liter water tanks. One tank is cooled to 8 degrees Celsius. The other is heated to 45 degrees Celsius. And I use a portable air conditioner, second hand. That was, of course, an air-to-air heat pump. In this video, I modified this into water-to-water. Yes, you have to do this conversion yourself with DIY. And why is it twice as efficient as a normal heat pump? Every kilowatt of electric power produces 3 kilowatts of cold and 3.5 kilowatts of heat at the same time. It charges both the cold and the hot tank. In a normal air conditioner, the heat is blown outside. Moreover, as told, I add thermal energy storage in the form of these two tanks. This allows you to reuse the two types of energy in both seasons, so summer and winter, for multiple purposes. This storage is also the reason that today's video is so wonderful for putting excess solar energy in it. I calculated in video 25C, and those are actually two videos, that the cost of storage is only 1.4 euro cents per kilowatt hour, against 10 times as much for standard lithium batteries that come with the installation of the photovoltaic plant on the roof. And each cubic meter tank can give you 12 kilowatt hours of energy storage. That would be a big investment with lithium. Now you can make the storage yourself. Now is the time to ask for your support for my channel. Your like and subscription will be like a vote to energy transition at home. Help also spread the word to family and friends and colleagues that suffer from the heat wave and are also frustrated about giving away solar electricity. A small contribution of each of us will stop the fever of the planet. Talking about heat waves, this free PDF here helps you to survive the next one with 15 simple tricks that you can realize already today. We are still at the start of August. This PDF is ready to be sent to you. I also am writing another PDF with schematics, calculations and specifications for the technology of today's video. I'm working on it, and you will have it at about 6th of August this year, 2025. Please click in the description on one of the links of this PDF or the one I talked before, so then I know which PDF to send to you as a welcome gift of the weekly newsletter full of information about energy innovation at your home. You can sign up for both PDFs without risk to receive each week the same newsletter twice. That's automatic here. Now, an additional benefit of the double test thermal energy storage for you. I hope you subscribed already and asked for at least one of the PDFs. And indeed, in the introduction, I promised to explain why this technology is also resilient in the case of a blackout. That's quite a bonus, right? How is it possible to continue cooling the house without the grid? Okay, you still need some electricity, but you should already have a lot of cold and heat in your two tanks. Maximum 12 kWh in each. A low consumption pump is enough to move that heat or cold where you need it. For example, in your cooling or heating network in your house. Ideal is it to have a 12-volt pump that runs on a battery also during a blackout. How does the heat or the cold go from the big tanks to your house? First, I want to challenge the belief that your home radiators are only made for warm water. For cold water, you need for each radiator a condensed tray under it and a set of computer fans on top of it. The fans transform your radiator in fan coils and give it more power. That's necessary in view of the lower density of energy in 8 degrees Celsius water as compared to the 50 degrees Celsius water that is usually flowing through it. And now you will have a radiator system that works not only in the winter. Anyway, the water in the radiator circuit must not be mixed with the water in the tanks. So I keep one submerged radiator as heat exchanger in both of the tanks. And when the winter comes, I only switch a 3-way valve between the two tanks. Now, and in this case, in this situation, the cold tank radiator pulls out the cold from the cold water without physical contact between the water in the circuit and the tank. And the warm water radiator extracts the heat from the warm tank. And in the summer, you can use both the heat and the cold. As said, the cold water goes to the radiators and the warm water can go to the boiler, the domestic hot water boiler, as preheater. That will also speed up the heating in the boiler. In the winter, you can use the cold if you have an application. For example, keeping cold very much food or starting in a holiday home for penguins. But for a household, it might be difficult to use it. And then the cold should be discharged to the environment by running the cold water through the air or through the ground. We have here a traditional Sicilian cisterna, which is a rainwater harvester, where we can hold 70 cubic meters. A seasonal storage is also an idea, but it is difficult to keep the cold for more than a few weeks. The exchange between the heat pump and the water tanks has been improved since last year. The portable air conditioners, condenser and evaporator trays are now directly placed on top of the big water tanks. And that's different from the last year's video 71. The trays are made from 2 halved jerrycans, acting as a bath for this evaporator and condenser, but I found already better trays. Heat and cold is transferred from these trays to the big tanks without long piping. Losses are minimized and the installation is simplified. As said before, more information about the technical features are available in my free PDF with schematics, calculations and the specifications. You can ask it in the description and then I will email it to you in a few days. You will also start to receive weekly emails with specialized content to become more independent and spend less money for energy. I respect your email box, as I am myself a victim of a rain of emails.